previously on Crisis.
Our corporate offices are in New York if you need anything.
We're working with Homes for Humankind to build houses in New York.
I'm your mother, Amber. I get to worry.
This is Agent Finley's first in a perimeter assignment.
But you'd take a bullet for me, right?
I was trying to protect your life. I wouldn't be here if I weren't.
We know who you are. We talked to the agents in that other SUV.
Movement!
Hurst? 15 seconds, a truck is going to pull up. You are going to get off this bus and onto that truck.
As you can tell from the way you were taken, we are professionals. If you do not respect that, we are also very comfortable with the use of force.
And I don't want to hear any of your too emotionally close to do your job clearly crap because your niece is on that bus. Your sister gives us access.
We're not on speaking terms, sir.
Now you are.
And you just want to see your kid.
I know I said I never wanted to, but now I need to.
Tell me what you see.
Two men, mid-20s, both unconscious.
Our men are dead. FBI has both soldiers.
We think he took those kids to use their parents. Morgan Roth, Dunn's sister, the ambassador, all used by the kidnapper. Do as he says or their kids die.
Call your friend General Osborne and tell him you need to meet with him alone. Tell him you have important White House business to discuss.
And the nature of this business?
Truth. Truth and pain.
Breaking news in the Ballard school kidnapping.
Now a tragic development.
A death today in the Ballard kidnapping case, but not of a child. This was a parent.
A parent dead.
Powerful citizen.
FBI.
Every parent's worst nightmare. Students of
Ballard High School. Press is going to have a lot of questions. They're going to want to know how that parent died.
That parent died for their kid because the kidnapper left them no choice.
Done?
If we do get their daughter back, how do we explain that to her?
You've been a congressman a long time, Mr. Worth. 4 terms. You sent a lot of men and women into battle. Today,
it's your turn. Do you understand how to use what I've given you?
Please don't make us do this.
Mrs. Worth, do you
understand how to use what I've given you?
Yes.
You're scared.
Make your love for your daughter stronger than your fear of what is to come.
You think I'll put that vest on?
Wouldn't you, to save your daughter?
No kids.
I'm sorry to hear that.
People who took your kids are using them as leverage. The people who took your kids are asking you to make an impossible choice. If you have been contacted, it is essential that you let us know. Do not comply with any demands. I know it's a difficult decision, so I'll make it easy for you to say no. As of this moment, each of you is the subject of an FBI investigation. Your movements will be watched. Your communications will be monitored. We will not let them use you. That is a promise.
Did you know the proof of life photo of Amber you gave me was part of the kidnapper's plan?
No. They told me I would see Amber, and they left that photo instead.
You weren't told to get that photo into the FBI?
No. You don't believe me.
I think you lied to me when you gave me that photo. I think you're lying to me now, and if I could prove it, I would lock you up. 2 days ago, you begged me to find her. I've never seen you like that. You were so scared. But this is the Meg I remember, the Meg who controls everything. Why the change?
No change. I'm still scared. I'm still begging you to find Amber. But I think you need to focus on the investigation and not on whatever hostility you have for me. If you want to find your daughter.
Do you know why the ambassador's son was let go?
I assume one or both of his parents did what the kidnappers asked.
Your wife did what they asked. Why didn't they let Amber go? Did you ask her? Aren't you curious? Because I am real curious about that.
If I tell you I don't know, you'll just tell me that I'm lying. Maybe you're not the right person for this case. You know your anger makes you careless.
My meds. Considering the circumstances, I'm adjusting the dose. Want a bump?
No, I don't.
Downstairs. Now! Everyone downstairs, now! Move, let's go! Let's go! Move it, move it, move it, let's go! Last names, A through M, to the right. M through Z, to the left. Move!
You will take a stack of money exactly 3 inches high. You will wrap this in foil. You will put 3 of these stacks in a bag. You will fill the rest of the bag with exactly 4 ounces of coffee beans. You will seal the bag and put 6 of these bags in a box. You will seal the box and stack the boxes. There are 250,000 bills here. You will not sleep until this is done. The group that stacks the most boxes will not be punished.
All right, let's go, move! Move, let's go!
Coffee?
For smuggling. Dogs won't be able to smell all that cash.
Congressman Worth? Congressman Worth? Mrs. Worth?
Can we help you?
I'm Agent Pender. We're the FBI escorts. We're on the first shift with you today.
There are so many of you.
2 for you, 2 for your husband.
Marie here is my chief of staff. Where I go, she goes.
Then it will just be the 6 of us. Shall we?
You want to tell me why you didn't want me in that interview with your sister?
No, I don't.
You recorded that interview so I can maybe listen to it later?
No, I didn't. You want to ask me any more questions on this line?
No, ma'am. Your family, your rules.
You back up your partner because that's what partners do?
That's how I learned it.
Except when they shoot you.
Except when they shoot you.
I'm Miss Fletcher. I work in the office here. Are you the FBI agents in charge of the parents?
Yes.
I just saw Mrs. Yarra, Senator Yarra's wife, lock herself in the band room.
Her daughter Sloan was on the bus.
Where is that room?
Down this hall.
Did you see what Mrs. Yarra was doing?
Yes, she was crying.
Lamborghini. Lamborghini. Lamborghini.
Luke, maybe you could stop that.
Maserati. Maserati.
He's whiffed.
What?
Luke, he's high. This morning in the shower, he was snorting his meds.
Perfect. Is Kyle doing it too?
No. Why? Are you blushing?
No. I got punched in the face, remember? It's bruised.
Keep working! Mrs. Yarrow, can you hear me?
And there I
go. Mrs. Yarrow, you need to open the door!
I can't see.
Her husband's a senator. He's got real power the kidnapper could use.
Where are those damn keys?
You got a call?
Yes, this morning. Mrs. Yarrow, open the door!
Mrs. Yarrow, open the door!
Don.
A ballot parent is on the damn news. I'm sending you a link right now.
What did the caller ask you?
To read this. We have taken your children. They're ours now.
You should have been more careful with them.
When they were with you.
Attempts to find them will result in their deaths. Attempts to find us will result in their deaths.
You had control. That is over. You had power. It is ours.
Wait, now that you've read that statement, your child gets to come home?
Stop talking now.
You need to turn that off.
No, no, not yet. There's more.
That's nasty of you.
Please, stop talking right now.
I get Sloan back after my husband does what they've asked him to do.
And which is what?
No, wait, out! What did the kidnapper ask your husband to do?
I don't know. I don't know what. I only know where.
Where did the kidnapper send your husband, Mrs. Jarrell?
They didn't send him anywhere. He's still here. Somewhere in this building. We need to evacuate the school. I want to thank you for everything you've done for my family today.
Your parents are like our family, Ballard. Your children are our children. All you had to do was ask.
It shouldn't be much longer. Here they come. I'm not sure I can do this.
Stay strong. We'll get your Sloan back home. SWAT and bomb squad just cleared that school. No sign of your husband, no sign of tampering of any kind. Where is your husband, Mrs. Yarrow?
I think it's time to put you two women in separate rooms.
You will go faster! You do not want to be on the losing side today.
It must be Aziz's parents' money. They must have paid his ransom, that's why he's out. They took your proof of life, so you'll be out too. She'll pay, and you'll be out.
Amber, I'm so sorry.
Sorry for what you did, or sorry for lying about it?
I'm sorry for hurting you.
Hey, kid.
Hey, stop.
He broke the rules.
Help me. Here, take the head back.
Hey, come on, come on. Jim, come on. Jim.
This boy needs help. Can you hear me? You need to come out of here.
Come on, Jim. Hey, stay with us.
He's not breathing. Tilt his head back.
Come on, Jim.
Meg, it's so good to see you. Have you seen any of the other parents?
This morning at the school.
How are they doing?
They're in shock. Frank, Beckwith, and Clark. Froy aren't there. Froy's been shot. Beckwith's arrested.
My husband's chief of staff. The kidnappers got to him in the White House. They made him torture someone.
My God.
Yeah. Oh, buddy, you got his kid back. They said you'll get him back if you torture someone, and Frank said yes. I'm gonna get a call. The amount of power my husband has. He won't do what they say, but I didn't take an oath. I'm gonna do something terrible to get Kyle back.
We take care of our children, Julia. That's what we have to do now. We can't leave this to others.
I know that this is hard for you not to be in control. We have to let the FBI do this.
What if they can't, Julia? This kidnapping is about us. Ambassador Rind, Morgan Roth, me, Beckwith, Froy, and soon you. We are being used. The FBI doesn't understand us. Not really. Make a call for me, Julia. Get me access to the FBI so I can see what it is that they're seeing. And I can help us get our kids back.
What if it's not enough? What if we can't?
save them. Make that call for me, Julia. The kidnappers are gonna come for all of us. We have to protect ourselves.
Any of you parents could get into that school. Why would the kidnapper waste a senator doing something there? Your husband was never at Ballard, was he?
We just wasted time and resources searching that school. Time and resources we need to find those kids. Help us. Where's your husband, Mrs. Yarrow?
My husband is out getting our daughter back. Why would you want me to stop him from doing that?
You were the one who told us where to find Mrs. Yarrow. You've been helping her right from the start.
I was, just trying to help.
Did you help Senator Yarrow, too? His car was still in the school's parking lot, but yours wasn't, Miss Fletcher. Do you know where he is?
Yes.
Do you know what he's doing?
Yes.
And if he injures other people?
That guilt belongs to the kidnapper. They made this happen. My husband is getting my daughter back. He knows it will ruin him, but he will get it done.
Where's your car?
I don't think I'm going to tell you that.
It won't take us long to find out.
That will be more time for Senator Yarrow to go get Sloan.
Last night, a man was tortured by one of the parents. Tortured and then made to kill himself. Your husband could be doing something very dangerous.
You're the ones who are dangerous. You will get my Sloan killed. You're dangerous if you stop my husband.
You!
What did I do?
We got some questions about where you used to work!
No! No!
Stop!
Get off me! Get off me! Don't ever touch me!
They were going to hurt you too.
It's your Secret Service guy in there. He's in there right now, and he's the whole reason that we're doing
this. All right, get to work, all of you! Now!
You okay? Your father used to work for the government, right?
We weren't supposed to talk about it. But he worked for the CIA.
CIA? They are totally gonna tune your father up. CIFNA.
Heart attack from the rifle blow. When a kid playing baseball gets hit with a pitch.
Except he wasn't playing baseball.
He broke the rules.
I didn't ask you to do this.
I got a pulse. He's unconscious, but at least he's breathing.
Boss, GPS shows Senator Yarrow on the move.
Where are the Worths?
Heading east.
And their FBI escort?
Right behind them. Four agents in one car about 10 feet back.
Open the secure line.
Yes?
Do you have the vest with you?
We do, in my briefcase.
Where you're going, we will no longer be able to communicate. It will just be you.
And what you need to do, do you understand?
We understand, you son of a bitch. And we'll do whatever you want us to do, but the FBI is right behind us. How do you expect us to lose them?
In 5 minutes, your FBI escort will be detained by local police. You will keep driving.
The 300 block of Jefferson, the west side of the street, you will find a white Accord. Unlocked. Keys under the seat.
Leave your own car. Take this one. Do you understand?
Yes.
And remember to bring the vest.
Please.
There must be another way.
Mrs. Worth, please tell your husband what you as a mother understand by now.
There is no other way.
Are you into DC Metro PD?
Yes. I've taken over police dispatch. We have 30 seconds.
Then do it.
All units, please be advised. Ballard kidnappers driving stolen black SUV. Government plates SG3874A heading east on Cordell. All units, suspects are armed and dangerous. Stop and detain.
How this works, you will be allowed limited access to facts not released to the public.
Limited?
It was not an all-access pass the Oval Office got you. You can ask about anything having to do with the other parents in Amber's class.
Well, other parents were used by the kidnappers. I want to find out what the other parents have done.
Well, may I ask why?
They got their children back, and I have not.
Morgan Roth helped bring down a surveillance drone. Ambassador Ryan was forced to allow access to classified information.
What information was that? Do I need to call the First Lady?
The ambassador didn't know what it was, so your question does not concern a parent. Anything else?
Yes, I need a file of everything you have that does concern a parent.
Ms. Fitch, what can you do with it that we can't?
I have four times your employees, a full 6,000 of which are PhDs and 10 times your budget. So I imagine quite a bit.
Which ones?
Metro PD was alerted that our FBI agents were the kidnappers. Eight units responded, pulled our guys over. By the time it was sorted out, the worst were gone.
Over here! I found something!
The bomb vest. First Senator Yarrow goes missing and now Congressman Worth. Why those two?
Access. They both have secure access to the Capitol building.
Call Olson. We need to lock down the Capitol.
All right, meal break! Let's go! Meal break! Move!
Get out of here. Nothing will ever be the same, will it?
No. Nothing will ever be the same.
It won't be about what happened here. Who got out, who didn't, who died. What they did to us.
Amber, I know you. You don't have to let this be your life.
But it is. It's already started. Good hands.
But I'm not a good person.
I've met a lot worse lately.
Break time is over. Amber, what do you think of my hands?
Wait. Done. The kidnappers had us chasing our tail all day. First the school, now the Capitol. Something's not right. The Worfs ditched their FBI escorts where?
Right here.
From the Ballard School that's headed away from the Capitol. Where'd they find Connie Fletcher's car?
Here, that's headed away from the Capitol building too. So if you start at the Ballard School, head past where they ditched their cars, and keep going, what else is out that way?
Langley, the CIA.
Finley, Worth and Yarrow both sit on intelligence committees, right?
Yeah, they do.
That gives them access to the CIA building. That black site we found was CIA. One of our hostages is ex-CIA, and now we have two parents with access to the CIA building. We sure see those three letters a lot lately.
Yes, ma'am, we sure do.
Don't call me ma'am.
That's a term of respect.
No, it's what cops call women they're forced to tolerate. We need to get to the CIA.
I'm so scared.
I know, I am too.
This is insane. We should call the FBI.
Just listen to me. The ambassador's son was let go. His parents must have done what was asked of them.
Did they have to put that on?
I don't know. But they're both still alive and their son is free. I want our daughter back. And I want her back now. Today. I'm glad we got the call, because we can do this.
I don't think I can put that on.
When the time comes, you will. You got a call?
This morning.
What do you have for us?
Is that vest real?
We don't have much time, Senator. What do you have for us?
A voice on the phone told me where to find this. It was in the vault. Here. Plug it into your phone. You gotta get 150 feet away from the building, otherwise the building will jam the cell phone calls. So you have to get that far, 150 feet. Is that vest real?
No, it's not. It's just a way we can get into the building.
But the guards don't know that.
What else do I need to know, Mason?
You take that flash drive out of the building, the built-in sensor's gonna trigger the alarms. Why the fake vest?
It's a diversion. He wears it, everybody looks at him, I walk the flash drive out of the building. You don't need a real vest for that.
But the armed CIA guards won't know that. I can't put it on, I can't.
We do what they ask, we get our kids back.
Then you put it on.
I'll do it.
Marie.
Shut up, don't say anything. Just take this, plug it into your phone. While everyone's looking at me, you get that 150 feet away from the building, you send them whenever they want to be sent, and you get our daughter back.
Marie.
I love you, Langston. Don't worry. It's gonna be okay. It's gonna be okay.
Stays unconscious, he's gonna need more care than I can give him. Where are the Worths?
In Yarrow.
They've just started now.
There's an injured child in there because of you.
He broke the rules.
So you disciplined him?
That's right. I did.
I'll handle this.
You do not touch these children unless I tell you. You do not decide discipline here. You're not a parent. How could you know?
Off the trigger.
I got her. You go after the other two parents.
You step back. Secret Service. I'm Secret Service.
You thinking about Charlene? You are, aren't you? Right now, she's all you can think about.
You know my daughter's name.
Step away, sir.
Worry about them. Or best, they'll use a sniper. We won't see him, but he's there, Marie.
Navajo 1, I have the shot and I'm waiting green light. What the? No shot.
You're doing this to save Charlene.
Navajo 1, I have no shot.
That sniper wants to shoot you, Marie. I will do my best to stand in his way.
Why would you want to do that?
It's kind of my job description. I don't know why the kidnappers want you dead, Marie, but I'm pretty sure it's not what your daughter wants.
Congressman Worth! Congressman Worth!
They are going to kill you.
Congressman Worth, I need that phone.
Not yet.
I need that phone.
Please.
Sir?
Not just yet.
Green light. Navajo 2, I'm on target.
I need that phone.
Please, not just yet.
You are a go, Navajo 2. Take her out.
The bomb's not real. The bomb's not real. Marie, where is your husband? What does he have
just
to do?
Just let him go, please. Just let him go.
Did it go? Do I get my kid back now?
Are you hurt?
Finley, get his phone.
Step away! I'm Secret Service.
Finley, do not let them take it.
CIA property, that's national security. Back up!
This is a crime scene and that is part of it, so all of this is FBI now. I need that phone and your statement, so back away. Finley, if we don't see what's on that phone, we're never gonna figure out what Worth sent to the kidnappers.
So let's get that phone. I'm gonna pick that up. You wanna shoot a federal officer? Go ahead. Do me a favor, aim for his side. I'm still tender over here.
Do not touch that phone! Hand over the phone, now! Step away!
What was it? Did you see it?
Video of some U.S. Special Forces. Night vision. Gun, it looked like they were shooting civilians.
I've seen a lot of things. Never anything like that.
You've been in a lot of firefights, haven't you?
I have.
What impresses you about this one?
Total lack of control.
Yes. The people in control were somewhere else at the time.
Where's Charlene?
When was the last time you saw her?
Last meal break.
Sloane's missing, too.
Did they take them? Did anyone see Sloane or Charlene get taken?
Is this it? Am I going home?
Boys on the phone told us where to go, what to do.
Did you see the video?
No.
You were alone with it, but you didn't watch it?
No, that's right. I made it exactly as we were told. Except he was supposed to wear the vest. But he couldn't. So I did, and now he's dead. Can you tell me what time it is? Please.
It's a little after three. Why?
In the flash drive.
It was where you said it would be.
You keep doing that, looking at your watch.
Yes. I have to wait until now to tell you something.
What?
I have to tell you 38.907-2309.
77.036-4641. I wrote it down so I wouldn't forget. See? Will you excuse me for a minute?
GPS coordinates, they each got half of the location.
It's around the block from here. What do you see, Finley?
Look at windows, rooftops, doorways. Look for people standing alone, looking down, looking in other direction from everyone else. Look for idling cars, backpacks, look for hands in pockets, combat boots. Look for cars that expire meters.
My name is Agent Susie Dawn. Are you okay?
Is it over? Is it over?
Amber Fitch. I've been selected by my captors to read this message. That man did not have to die today. That was the CIA who did that shooting. Congressman Worth's blood is on the CIA, not us.
Amber? This is Agent Susie Dunn. I'm with the FBI.
My father's dead?
I'm not going home, am I?
Go back to work.
Charlene's father's dead. My best friend's dad.
You didn't know, did you?
My dad. What are you doing to him? When can he come back out?
By leaving them just around the block from the FBI, he's saying he's better than us, smarter than us. He can come onto our street, and we can't stop him.
I have access to the surveillance cameras on that block. Here it is.
Fix that. Fix it, now.
It's not the equipment. It's him. Those cameras use infrared. If he's wearing infrared LEDs and a hat, no one around will notice. But on camera, it comes out like that.
My name is Amber Fitch. I've been selected.
We got this, but he bounced the signal too much to get an origin.
That man did not have to die today. That was the CIA who did that shooting. Congressman Worth's blood is on the CIA, not us. My name is Amber Fitch.
This side wins. You will get dinner. You will sleep in a bed. This side loses. No dinner, and you will sleep on the floor tonight. Now go wash up. You all stink of money.
Hold on that one. Push in on that. Identify that location.
Those are onlookers outside the Pakistani embassy, Washington, D.C.
What is it? What do you see?
I know him. He used to work for me.
What did he do?
You know, we do a lot of business with the CIA. He was our liaison.
Why did he stop working for you?
Something horrible happened.
Changing shifts.
You're supposed to leave when you see someone like this.
Yeah.
Why is that?
Because it's ugly.
But I don't want to leave.
You want to know why?
I know why. You want to feel something that's just yours?
Yes.
That no one else can touch?
Yes.
I know what that's like. I know what that's like.
You don't know. How could you?
He was in the video I saw at the CIA.
You're sure?
I'm sure. He was one of the soldiers we took out of the Pakistani embassy.
If this kidnapping is about the CIA, we don't talk on the phone about it, we don't email about it, we don't speak of it at FBI headquarters. This is the kind of investigation that ruins careers and gets people dead. So it's just you two and me.
A look at what's coming up on the next all-new Crisis on NBC. Next Sunday, as they get closer to the truth.
These soldiers connect us to the kidnapper. We can't lose that connection now.
They're running out of people they can trust.
CIA just lied right to my face.
Amber is my daughter.
What is that?
NBC's Crisis, all new next Sunday.